I'm Jane Pelletier. I'm music teacher at Normandy Elementary at Jeff Cove School. And I am going to identify and just walk through the IEG, the individual educator goal that I had picked last year, which I am also doing this year. It's for fifth grade, and I picked a classroom here that was identifying rondo form, which is part of our makeup, our elements of music. And I focused in on their cooperative as well as enjoyable experience, because that's one of our CAP focuses for this trimester, as well as then we worked on working on analyzing and evaluating, which is a DOK, fourth level, so it's a higher level of thinking and reflecting that students do personally as well as within the group. The essential question within this main focus of rondo form was, can you use rondo form to make a musical composition or performance? And from there, these students had to express in body and in voice their success through demonstrating the understanding of rondo form in movement, as well as in singing. They were writing a short narrative to then explain that they understood it, and also then they were to analyze and evaluate themselves, and I have attached one of the forms that I used for their own personal evaluation, their group evaluation, and then they shared within the whole classroom an evaluation. Clearly, music doesn't have a scoring process. Do students know or not? Don't know rondo form? So I had to have them first have a baseline, which was a written narrative. So they wrote down what they thought it was. Then I introduced to them a swing song, and we discussed a little bit of the historical value of World War II, swing bands, entertainment. So we had some historical understanding how this music was evolving at that time. And then they understood how this one particular song was rondo form. So in order to get a baseline, I had students write down what they thought rondo was in a narrative form, and I equated the points. Low would be they got 0 to 3 points, moderate understanding 4 to 5, and of course if they were over the charts, they were 6 and above, they were high understanding. Most students, to be really honest with you, had no idea, so they were right here. So my intent was surely they would grow with what we were doing. Doing this performance, they were able to use their body. If they are not very good or feel comfortable in singing or narrating what rondo form is, then they could express themselves through movement. So we did a performance. Each group were able to practice. They demonstrated rondo form, and then they were videotaped. So what I did as a post-assessment was they wrote narrative form. Some people are a little bit better at articulating than others, so not only was that part of their narrative, part of their scoring, but I also included the performance part, which demonstrated to me that they understood what rondo form was. So movement was part of that scoring. Creativity, expression, did they go above and beyond just simply moving their fingers and moving their bodies? Did they add props? Were they singing along with? The type of movement. Some students were very creative with that. And then I looked at the teamwork. Not only were they helping each other with the performance, but they were also helping each other understand when to change. This is A section. Gotta go. They always had somebody who cued someone in their team who might not have been really secure with it. So teamwork was really big. So it showed me their strengths and understanding of rondo. So that was all factored in, so that I could understand if they made growth, and that's how I charted it. So some narratives, examples were written like this. Rondo form is a pattern of A, B, A, C, A, D. A is always the same, like boom, boom, boom. B, C, D is always different, like boom, pop, and so on. So that's one student's example. Here's another student's example of writing. Rondo form is a pattern of A, B, A, C, A, D, A clap, B singing, A clap, C stomp, A clap, etc. Then we're going through. Some people were great at articulating, and other people struggled. They could tell me, but they couldn't write it down. So therefore, that's why I was trying to balance out their scoring by using performance. So that's how I used my IEG for last year and this year. I said most of them were pretty much not understanding what Rondo form was. I gave them daily grades, so I knew that they were understanding or not understanding, so I could assist them. So that was my piece of monitoring them as they were progressing. Then for those who were able to really articulate in writing, they were even able to kind of advance a little bit farther up the scale of understanding. This footing of performance put everybody on an equal plane, if you will, that everybody could move. Everybody could create a performance to demonstrate. This then helped their students to go into the moderate level. Anyone who was even went above and beyond, whether they were always the team leader and I could see that they understood, or if they wrote articulated very clearly, their understanding, they even stretched up to the high. So there was a little bit of spread there. But most people worked right around in that moderate level. So I could see growth, and that's basically it.